Greg will order up to 235 times 400 bottles. Dr. Arizona and you are driving on the driver's coach, and we are still waiting for some kids at there, but we can stop. Our first question is what we should take over there when we're coaching young runners, for example, 14, 15 years old. What do you think? And what's the most important?
Of course, you must know what is a boy or girl start before age 14. But to check training, training amounts and then to try to teach good technique, running technique, and then more and more running, easy running and speed. Work and so on, speed thing. And I think this is the point to start. It's a big answer if I take everything I know and then start.
Okay, what other questions do you think about that?
I would say if you asked one, the most important thing with the kids is that to act as a coach, to have their passion on sport so that they love it and they like it and they want to do it. I think that's the most important thing.
All right. Okay. And any questions for this? And if Ronald is a little bit older, 16, 18 years old, what do you think, what we must they consider in this case? More likely to have it, more training volume, more weight training, or intervals, or?
All those, but I think speed is, speed and technique, they are the most.
I think that the key thing is what the young person have done before, because they are so different. If we only think the age, for example, 17, but we don't know what kind of athlete he or she is. It's very difficult to say to what things should we concentrate. But if everything has been done well before, so I mean a lot of different things, not to concentrate too early. For example, only the speed training, jumping, running in the forests, and so on. So the basics must be learned. And after that, person is, for example, 16, you concentrate on technique. Actually, I think it was about 3 years ago, I met Kent Olsson in Sweden, and he said that first comes the technique, then the speed, then the strength, and the last thing is the speed endurance. And I believe.
What do you think about rest day? Is it better training every day? Times per week? 14 times you have.
I don't know the right answer, but we have in those hard weeks we have one test a day. And in easy weeks, one or two. But I think one rest day for a sprinter is minimum.
How we change our training when we come in order around 22 years old? Is that the right time to start real speed general training? What do you think about that?
You're asking me?
Oh, maybe I'm also.
If everything has been done correctly, optimally as has done very excellent work, so we can move more lactic speed and endurance, making real result out.
Is it better to develop anaerobic capacity, or is it better training anaerobic economy? More important runs, several can meet at possible, or that you have so high lactic as tolerance as possible.
I think both of those are important. If you talk about the old athletes, adult athletes who are in their elite phase. So most of the athletes can improve their performance at that phase by improving their economy. But if that is the same in endurance athletes, and I think it's also the same in speed endurance. If you look at the data and the results, she couldn't improve her speed, maximum speed, in a round phase, for instance. But I think she could improve her speed, economy in running.
How we can develop running economy?
Doing very special training. So in other place, you should specialize your training. That even if you are boxing.
Okay.
That's the key thing.
Is it better doing more circuit training, weight training, or jumping?
If you talk about running point or running point or whatever, the most important training sessions are running.
Do you have questions, Nico? This is for Ronald. If I remember right, yesterday that you told me that too often, too early, young sprinters are running 400 meters. You have your own coaching philosophy on how to prepare them to the 400 meters. Can you tell us?
Just what I'm believing is if you start early with them, it's like I said yesterday, it's a very heavy acid training. And I think we can destroy them very early if we go too hard. Also a lot of aerobic training in early ages. I mean, that's what I learned once from the professor, don't do too much. Because you have to see so many years before you. To what can I do next year? How can I put on more training? What can I do? So I think, I don't have the answer, but I think about around 18 years old, I think you can put more training. Could be a little bit harder. But if I want to get seniors, I don't think I can start so early. So So I don't have any youngsters, and I will never take a girl 15, 16 years old and just running 400. I will do anything to get her more, get more speed on her, to get her faster, then put on longer and longer races, sessions. So I think I can only say what I have seen. I've seen so many disappear in Sweden. I think it's the same in Finland. So what are we doing? It's something maybe we don't do that's good for them. And we have to put them first, not ourselves as coaches. It's not important that I have a 16-year-old girl who's best in Finland or Sweden. That's my problem. How do we develop them to be a good center?
You are?
I actually have a question for Ronald about Muva's training. How much does he train the basic aerobic training in a different part of the
world? This is the big question. I talked about it like what Nick Bidot said. Now we've been out in the woods 8 weeks. Don't forget that we are out running in the woods 8 weeks. 5-6 weeks for Moa. This has been out 8 weeks. And we start with 3 kilometer jogging, and then we have all these races that I showed. It could be 9 races, 10 races, 11. So I think it's a lot of training already there. So I don't think I will have to go out and do much more intervals. And then you have also the how is the person that you train? I have Moa. If I say to her, like I said, go this year I'm going to run 600, 500, 400, I think she's going to shoot me. So how shall I mentally prepare her to, if we go Rio, we have maybe to put in one more day running, we have to increase. Is she fast enough? Can I go up to 500? Is that going to work? That's the question I ask myself. Because without the speed, as I said, we're not going anywhere. And I can also see myself, if you go down over one second in 200 meters, something happens at 400 meters when you're really good training. Difficult to answer, but I think around 18 years old, I think we can put a little more training.
I have also a question to you, Ronald. Do you have in Sweden, at the age of 16, 17, 300 meters in competition or more, 400 meters?
There is some 300 meters, but it's very odd in Sweden because we have 400 meters indoor for youngsters. Isn't that easy? I mean, when you're 16 years old, we don't have 200 meters. But we have 400 meters, yeah. And I think that's terrible. That's telling the coaches that run 400 meters. No, run 200 meters.
We are going to the same bad situation in Finland.
Yeah. Because, like I said, if you have a Johan Wissman, then you can be happy, because he's so strong. He's so mentally strong. But is everybody that? Not me, not more.
How about Maxima Rotterganappe? Do you think so that we need also high oxygen training for 400, 800? And if we're doing just too much, what happened to our speed? We recommend yesterday that if you would like to run very fast, you maybe need 70. 400 and more for 800. Is it better looking slow talents? Runners who have 70 minutes before training.
It is good if an athlete has 70 milliliters, and athlete who could run 100 meter about 10 seconds and has 70 milliliters per kg of maximum amount, that's good. But if you think about the training itself, it is waste of time to improve VO2 max in 400 meters. You cannot have so much benefit from that kind of training than you have and what you can have from speed training, for instance. That's my
I agree.
But on this we see that we have good 400 meters runners, so but they have this 70 meters or so, and then they develop speed. And like we see Wilson, I believe she's done a lot in Kenya, and then develop speed. So what do you think, should we change something maybe in athletics when they're 10 years old? Are we doing not too much Arabic work when they're really young kids? What do you think? What do you think?
I don't know how everybody trained, but yeah, if you're 10 years old, then you're supposed to play.
Yes, of course. Although I don't mean football right now, that's okay, but you can do Arabic work.
Yeah, no, I would never do Arabic work. If you have someone who wants it, I mean, you have a personality, they want to run, yeah, it's okay, but I would never put an aerobic training on a young soldier. I mean, we have a sport, we have a really, track and field is really wonderful. You can start track and field whatever you want, almost. I think we forget that sometimes, just to know. I mean, you can play football and you can quit 15, 16 years old and you cannot go over to track and field. We have so many cases.
And football, you make
it. Yeah, and they play handball and they play table tennis and they play tennis. Axel Bergman, we have he's a tennis player. He just started to run. He was quickly done for himself.
But if we look at what the footballers do when they're 10, they run, then you never can.
The ball is made to move and to do something and to train. But I will never in that respect take a 10-year and start to train 300 meters, do you understand? Go out and run, one finish me, then switch me. No.
May I have a comment? I literally disagree with Ronald in this case. Because I think it is important to have a lot of aerobic growth when you are young. Is that place as important as to do different kind of sports, so you learn different kind of techniques and so on, different sports and so on. But it is also important to have Arabic work, because Arabic work, that's also easy work. It is easy to recover from Arabic work. It does do have any harmful effect to other things. So I think that's why it's important also to have Arabic work in young kids.
Yeah,
nice
question. Just in Ireland, a lot of other top 400 runners came across from these backgrounds. So at a young age, it would have been an awful lot of road to one more. Like, our Irish record were 44.7, like 200 PB, 21.2. Like, so that kind of is evident that, that maybe is a road component kind of pattern to where he was in the
aren't important, basically, the ground is in England, the one kind of
walking to school and back, more than 20 kilometers in a week. And we had to change the training when she started high school, because she won't walk anymore. And everything like that dropped out. So we have to increase the aerobic training. And unfortunately, I think that at the moment, that's a problem, that the kids don't move as a hobby, as more as they did before. Actually, yeah, I have a question again for Ronald. What kind of tests do you use? For example, basic endurance test or something like that?
Well, I don't use many tests. Maybe flying 30, and then I think I'm more interested if what the Moa and Neil and everybody is doing on 120 meter max, 150 meters max, 250 meters max. That's more important for me. 300 meters, because Neil can go out and be the fastest guy even today on 400 meter in relay and everything. He has the fastest time in the world championships and so on. He's not 400 meter trained. So maybe he has a big capacity, but so I don't do so much tests. We have this oxygen in the team, VO2 max. I don't think she wanted to get too tired. I think she has around high 50 or something. But when we grow up, I mean, we were all the time outside playing, and we had the VO2 max when we started. I started boosting it was like a short sprint to 65 or something, 60. Because we were always doing something, playing. So that's important for the children today. But I don't think, I mean, so you don't misunderstand me. It's, for me, it's not starting training a 10-year-old girl. I mean, too early. Mm-hmm. Don't specify in that age. That's for me. It's not in my imagination, but they have to move and they have to run every day, maybe. Yeah. So I understand your question, but I answered, don't start early. Specific.
Hi.
Yes. There in Finland, we are very keen in with numbers and more kind of training systems. I ask, what kind of lactate levels we can use in the different workouts. Maybe Ari Numa answered that. And then I asked Rolle, do you use lactate measuring level? For example, in Rolle's example yesterday, you had in 1 week you had four different intervals. So could Ari tell what kind of lactate levels they mean? When it's basic training, for example, in December.
Yeah, I think on this table, this lactate levels were very well shown. But I would say that when you do low intensity intervals, like extensive intervals, yeah, and in those training, the aim is to improve the aerobic capacity. Then the lactate levels would be maybe below 7 millimoles or something. from 4 to 7, usually for 400 runners. And then I could say that for most athletes, the level about 12 millimoles is the level where you can see fatigue in movement. So if the lactate levels are above 12 millimoles, then you can see that technique is changing for you. So that is, I think, is also quite important to know.
it's easy to see when the athletes are totally exhausted, and it's Saturday. When we do 180, 60, 40, that 280 meters just walking down, and the speed is up to 90-95%. And after that, three series, I think they lay down for 15-20 minutes. So it's a lot of acid in that, because the speed is so high. I mean, that's really gives something. And if you look at the weightlifters, they always use about 85-90% to degrees to be better, up to 95%. Maybe also we should look sometimes how many percent we are using.
Okay, there.
Just for the health balance, what do you think is the most times per week, say for a microcycle, that an athlete should train high level lactate for optimal adaptation?
Regarding elite athletes, probably two times per week during a few weeks in April, 4 weeks, probably May, one week more, two times per week, but it's absolutely maximum. Probably one per week is very safe. When regarding very high,
I think like if we have a professor, we know if we do very hard acid training, we talk about 48 hours. If you don't know that, you can really destroy the person. But what are you going to train after you've been training such a hard running exercise? If it takes 48 hours to transport it, that's telling me something. Okay. It has to be another form of training of that. You can't do the same. Because the body is just going down.
Okay, when we're training very hard, we know that 400, 800, and they are very hard distance. How we can train in mental side? Or do you train mental
side? Just use the American way. Focus.
Do you know what happened there? The matter before end. Who is the man who can go in? Okay. More questions?
For Roland. Like yesterday you mentioned that you don't rhythm your weeks, like there's a tough week and an easier week. So how do you control that you don't overreach or overload the athletes?
Well, that's once again what I go. I look at my athletes all the time. So I don't have too much running in the week. Sometimes I go down to just 3.200, 3.250, and then I do something less. I always try to look at them, what have they been done, and what have they been done. Maybe I have to change the training tomorrow because they're very exalted today. So that's the way I live. Just never have a paper, I have to do what I have been writing down. I can always change. So I think I go more for the feeling. I don't never ever have a statistic and check myself. I go only what I see. Because you can see a lot as a coach. You're standing there.
But it's very well discussed and vision also.
Yeah.
And about
racing 400 meters. I don't mean splits. First 100 or 200, second 200 and 200. But is it possible to how it's possible? What are your thoughts about how to improve results by? Using maybe rhythm things or playing with strength. stride frequency, stride length? Is there maybe different tasks for one commit for first quarter than half and so like you can see in glide cards. Philosophy, push, base, position and pray, and what do you think about that? For whole body.
I try not to think too much. I never clock my Kantolson. I have Kantolson the other. He always take a time on 200 and so on. So my philosophy is that they have to learn what's a good opening for you. I mean, Mo is not trained for maybe the really go the last 50 meters, but sometimes even in Helsinki she was managed because she was opening a little bit slower. And in that race, it was very good for her because she was much, much stronger and more mentally there in the final. Sometimes she has been open in the indoor championships. She opened in the semi-final 23.65, first 200 meters. That's really tough for her, but she managed. But in the final, she opened slower and take a medal. And I think you have to learn them. They have to find their own way. I'm not the person who can sit there and write down everything and try to get an answer. I mean, Johan Wisman is running hard, and that's something we have looked at. He's opening very hard at 300 meters.
Outside of those splits. Do you teach you, for example, how to run after 200 meters or maybe second curve or first curve? Or
it's like standing in the paper. You have to have a good first 100 meters, then you have to go very relaxed after 200 meters at a good speed, and then you have to really start working from 200 to 250 meters until 300 meters, so you're in the race. But some people open very slow, and it's very strong in last 200. I think it's very personal. I mean, Ella was very close to Moa in Gothenburg, and she's a couple of tenths behind on 200 meters. She was very strong. So,
what do you other people think?
I've been listening to Kai Pyle, and I like his ideas, and so I agree with him that in the training you should concentrate on different parts of 400 meter. You have to learn how to run the 400 meter to have the optimal results, and this is even more important in 400 meter hurdles, because you have to have fixed number of steps between the hurdles. It is very important to teach the athlete how to run to get the optimal results, but also in all the way.
I was about to say that the last season was the first one in the world to learn to run 400 meters. Usually the first 200 meters were too fast. A good example was May 2012. We came straight from the training camp to compete. The first 300 meters was 37.5. And the last 100 meters was 18.
Okay,
Hunter
first and
over. I will add a little bit more. We made years ago EMC measurements during 400 meter running, and it seems that between 200 and 300 meters there is a strong decrease in relaxation, and athletes should try to run very relaxed this pace from 200 to
400 meters, perhaps even 1500 meters. Many runners say that they need also in trainings, they need people who face them and they train together and so on. Yeah. You almost never raced 400, almost never 1500, and you were training alone almost always. So is it because of the right attitude? You can do the hard trainings, you don't need any other people there. You can do it alone, don't need training competitions.
Well, is that a question? Because I mean, people, they have been good physical results, but they train in the group or in people, but they, maybe I was almost the only one training alone. But this was the reason why I used to train alone, it was more, I could understand myself and get the feeling and analyze my running. Because if we are running as a two people, maybe three. So normally, you know, you can see the time for number one. Even if the coach say, okay, we're 51. So it's 51 for number one person, but then what about number four person? Is it still 51 or? And that can make confusion for many athletes. So what is progress and what is not progress? But it was more focused on individual. Because more running is about you, is about me. So I decided to do it alone. And I wanted to like experiment in myself and analyzing my competition. Every competition I run, so I had to know that maybe my first 100 was too fast this time. What do I have to do next time to adjust to run better the last 50 meters? Because if you look at it, then when my side changed, so my strongest part was the last 200 meters. And they said, when you do the training as a group, you know, so you cannot adjust, you cannot get the feeling, right? You get tired. Because somebody is in front of you, you are not feeling any tired, you still feel okay. But then, for you in your mouth, you in your mouth. Yes. So I decided to do that for two reasons. Just to understand myself. And to keep my rhythm, not to lose the rhythm on the ground. Because if somebody is in front of you, sometimes you get too close. So you cannot keep your rhythm from the other. And that's that. That was my own observation and my way of thinking. And then also about talking about the attachment and the running. So this is another thing. If you train in the athletes, as always. So you have to say, okay, in the competition you did last week, you ran past 200, you get tired in the last 50. So can you try to run a little bit, almost even time, but finish very small? So since you know you have also understanding of the rhythm, that's the rhythm we need to think that it's not that something to understand.
Thank you. Any other questions?
So would you be over or under 2 minutes? 2 minutes at the moment.
Under 2 minutes, yes.
Well, you're talking so much about this rhythm, but in the interview race, there's always a tactical aspect as well. Do you think about that? And how did that affect you in the races?
No, I've been thinking of, but maybe before, when I was running some competition, I was maybe in between pushing with people, but then after really understood how to run it. And so I would start from behind, keep my rhythm going, getting faster and faster without pushing anyone. So this the tactic also for training. And then when I was really good, shape and confident, so after the lead from the beginning. So I control the race and I control my rhythm. But that's also in the training. So it's very tricky because I kind of I cannot pull it very tough, but it's not easy to run because there's pushing, there's you know, the swing, you have to overtake. But sometimes, you know, the athletes can get panic, you know, and you want to overtake in the swing. So they will be pushed and give them fire for them. Hey, you lose your rhythm, try to come back. So it's better to do it. And there's a little bit of straight back. There's a lot really we need to do in our running, not only in 800, but all the running.
Okay, Marco, please.
Wilson, you mentioned that the weakness
last 200 meters turned out to be your strongest spot. What changed in your training to make it possible? Running, strength training.
But that's a good interesting system, and I was playing, you know, maybe we are making a mistake, because I saw some more presentation yesterday. Somebody ran in 400. So you could see nobody was training over 400. They trained less than 400. But to make it more better is you have to think back and you have to think over. If you run 500 and come to run 400, 400 is going to be easy. Because you say, if you do also bench press, I say, if you take 70 kilos and come back to take 60, it's going to be easy. So this more have to be more logic in training to see what are you looking for. So you have to be stronger to run longer. You can resist. So when you are running 400, to maintain the same speed already, you need to run longer than that so you can run the same speed every lap. You saw my in-laws record, so I could stay almost like 26.2, 26.00. So that's the consistent of training. You need to maintain that so you can keep the same speed, the same rhythm, the same steps. Of course, if you get tired, it can be smaller, but then if you maintain as much as possible.
Okay, thank you for the panel. And now I think that it's time that we're doing the conclusion. Very hard job, of course, doing this conclusion. I made this assessment. Isn't it easy? Is the professor at Geneva, please?
Thank you.
Surprised.
Dear friends, we have had very excellent 3 days and 2 nights here in Pajulahti, excellent facilities and so on. And we have enjoyed being here. And I would like to shortly summarize the presentations we have had here and with what we have probably learned. First, Natalia Antiuk and Katariina Kulikova, in their presentation, I think the key points were planning, how to plan year by year, how to become a super Olympic athlete, and also how to use drills, a lot of drills, and to do these drills technically correctly. And also a lot of, I understood a lot of extensive intervals training. And then Juha Sainio did a very excellent presentation regarding young girl, how to keep on training and how to keep, I think Ella has kept a very exact training diary. Probably you have escaped. And in Finland we have problems because the athletes are not keeping training diaries nowadays. Earlier we get a lot of training diaries. And also in Juha's presentation was a very key point that how he changed training program regarding this interval training and care to the health. And regarding Ronald, the presentation, I think that what we learned was that coach must be very, I would say, in when he's standing and looking at the athlete. This discussion and all this psychological, practical psychology is very important also. And then Wilson, Peter, gave very excellent
grip area and also we would see how his career was progressed, and the final results are very excellent. And I think Wilson is one of the most fantastic, best running athletes ever in the world. And then going to this scientific area, Ari did a very excellent presentation, and I think the terms overreach and overtrain are very important to know and understand and separate. And then also Ari gave the data how to try to prevent overtrain. In my own presentation, there was a summary of demands for the elite 400-meter runner, and also some principles for training, of course, my topics. And then we had, I think, two technology presentation, innovation presentation, and say this is normal life nowadays. We have business world also inside our excellent sport. And then finally, what did we really learn, and what are the messages to take home? I have 3 points. First, programming training from child to elite athlete to understand this big progress is a key point. And then detail inside this is that athletes should keep more training diaries. Second is going practice this hip area. It's very important that the hip area is around the hip angle very flexible. We have strength in that area because it's the heart of movement running. And the third one is this 200 meter time, record time should be all the time improve, and then we have possibilities to be excellent 400 meter runner. And finally, I think Biolahti will give on conferences. So 1 year, 2 years, once again, we have, I think, excellent conference coming on. And I think we have had a very excellent conference, and thank you for you being here. Thank you for organizing. Now, probably, you have the next words. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Merrill. And so, coaches, now go to home and take care of you. Runners, now we know that we should concentrate to our own runners. So, that they can do themselves to job as possible next time of run 400 goals or maybe 800. And welcome next year, after 2 years, again to Taiwan. Thank you very much.